So hi, hello and welcome again, Microbehunter here, and today in this video I would like to explain to you two methods that allow you to slow down microorganisms to the extent that you can watch them and observe them more easily under the microscope. So I need to explain maybe the background a little bit here. When you put a water sample under the microscope, for example, and when you see those microorganisms, then many of them are simply too fast and they like to swim away. And as soon as you see them under the microscope, they're already gone and it's difficult to chase them. And therefore, it's also difficult to get a good image or good video. And for this reason, you probably want to slow them down somehow. And I'm going to basically explain to you now two methods on how you could do that. And by slowing them down, you can of course also zoom in much more. You can use a higher magnification and therefore you can also see the details of the cell that you're looking at much better. And there are a variety of other advantages here. Of the two methods that I'm going to show you, you cannot say that one of them is automatically better than the other. Both of them have their own advantages and disadvantages. Probably you want to use both of them basically be able to see better than what you want to see, right? So let's dive in right away. The first method, if you want to slow down microorganisms, is simply, you just limit their movement. How can you do that? Let's look at paramecium, for example. It's a single-celled microbe. If you use very little water as a mounting medium, then the ciliate, the paramecium, is sandwiched and squeezed in between the cover glass and the microscope slide. And there's a very thin film, a very thin layer of water. The cell is in between there, and then basically, it's inhibited in its movement because from the top you've got the cover glass pressing down, and the bottom you have this microscope slide. And then basically the friction of the two glass surfaces slows down the cell sufficiently that it's not able to move very quickly, and then you're able to see it much better. And this has, of course, also another advantage, and that is that because it's pressed so flat, pretty much all of the parts of the cell are in focus at all times, and this means that you're able to observe the cellular processes that are happening much better. For example, you're able to look at the cilia, which are the tiny little hairs that are moving, especially also around the mouth of the paramecium. You can also observe the so-called contractile vacuole, which pumps out water. So there are a range of advantages that this method has, especially if you want to do a little bit of cell biology or at least some observation of life processes. However, there is, of course, now a disadvantage, and that is you've got to be careful, because if the water evaporates too much, then essentially the layer of water becomes thinner and thinner and thinner, and then sooner or later, what's going to happen is the cell might actually burst, right? And then it pops open and it's dead. Also interesting to look at, but essentially that's sometimes that you don't want that to happen, obviously, because then you're not able to observe the cell very well. Another disadvantage is because it's pressed so flat, it's kind of wider now, and it kind of loses its natural shape. So it's much more oval right now, of course, because if you squeeze something together, then of course it widens up and becomes wider. And this is actually also something that we're able to see here. Yeah, but generally, that's usually the first thing that I try out, is I try to limit the amount of water, and this basically also gives an overall better image, simply because the cell is not able to swim up and down. It's always staying in the same level, and basically everything is in focus. So you have a lot of control basically over the when you make videos or pictures. Now the second method is a little bit slightly more advanced, and that's also a method that I like to use quite frequently, and that is you add a substance that is very thick, very viscous, like for example in this case methyl cellulose, which you can quite easily make yourself. And because it's so viscous, like honey, for this reason, the cells are not able to move as quickly anymore. And therefore, it slows them down, and you're able to see them much better that way. The advantage of methyl cellulose is that the original cell shape is retained. Yeah, so you can actually see that the cell is actually much elongated, almost like a cylinder. You can actually see also the cell rotating around. And essentially, you see the natural behavior of the cell much better, but everything is much slower because of the highly viscous solution. For this reason, it's not able to move quite as quickly. There is, of course, also another disadvantage of methyl cellulose, and that is that because it's very thick and very viscous, it's difficult to actually limit the thickness of the layer of liquid. And therefore, the cell is also able to move up and down a little bit, and therefore it's moving in and out of focus, and therefore it can be a little bit more difficult to chase in that way, in a vertical movement, so to say. Some parts are a little bit blurry again, and you have to refocus. It's simply another disadvantage. The cool thing about methyl cellulose is that it does not really impact very much on the osmotic balance of the cells. So I've really not seen that the cells burst because of water going into the cell, or shrivel up because too much water is lost. So really, the osmotic balance is not really changed. That's actually something good. Just everything slow down. If you want to make methyl cellulose yourself, I recommend that you take 0.2 grams of methyl cellulose and add approximately 10 milliliters, 10 grams of water. You resuspend this properly. You wait maybe for a day or so for the methyl cellulose to completely dissolve. And then you get a very clear and very viscous solution. This is basically that you add. And I usually add about approximately the same amount of methyl cellulose, and you can adjust a little bit the amount of methyl cellulose that you add to the drop of water. The more that you add, the slower the microorganism is able to move. And a little bit of a disadvantage, again, of course, is that sometimes there are quite a lot of bubbles formed this way. But generally, when you put the cover glass on top, then many of the bubbles are actually pressed to the side again and disappear, so even that is not a big problem. And then you're also able to see, like, those two conjugating paramecia here, they're exchanging DNA. They have now joined up and they're exchanging DNA now, something that would have not been possible for me to observe without slowing it down, because they're simply too fast. But now we're getting a very good view of that. I'm going to now simply say goodbye to you. I would like to invite you, of course, to subscribe to the channel if you like these type of videos. All the best, happy microbe hunting as always, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.